Hello viewers, welcome to my channel Human Diseases and Genes. In this video, I will discuss about diverticulosis. Diverticulosis is a condition where a small bulging pouches called diverticula form in the lining of digestive tract, most commonly in the colon, that is large into large intestine. These pouches develop at weak spots in the intestinal wall and are usually harmless and asymptomatic. Risk factors for diverticulosis are aging, more common after age 40, low fiber diet, sedentary lifestyle, obesity and smoking. Most people with diverticulosis have no symptoms. Common symptoms of diverticulosis are mild abdominal cramping or discomfort, often in the lower left side, bloating, changes in bowel habits, constipation, diarrhea and blood in stool, etc. Two conditions, diverticulosis and diverticulitis, are different. Diverticulosis is simply the presence of these pouches, whereas diverticulitis is the inflammation or infection of one or more of these diverticula, often causing symptoms like sharp abdominal pain, fever, nausea, and vomiting. Diagnosis may be done by colonoscopy, CT scan, and barium enema. Treatment of diverticulosis without complications, a high fiber diet, and stool bulking agents may be recommended. But diverticulitis requires prompt medical attention and may involve antibiotic or liquid diet or in severe cases surgery. Diverticulosis treatment focuses on managing complications, that is like diverticulitis, rather than the presence of the diverticula themselves, which are pouches in the colon wall. For diverticulitis, treatment may include a temporary liquid diet, antibiotic, pain medication, and rest. Severe cases or complications like abscess, fistula, or obstructions may require hospitalization with IV antibiotics, drainage procedures, or surgery to remove the affected colon segment. Long term of high fiber diet and supplements can help prevent complications. For uncomplicated diverticulitis, that is mild cases, a short period of clear liquid diet is often recommended, followed by a gradual return to high fiber diet. Oral antibiotics may be prescribed to treat the infection or inflammation. Over the counter pain relievers like acetaminophen or antispasmodics may be used. Giving the bowel a rest can help symptoms ease. For complicated diverticulitis cases, intravenous antibiotics and hospitalization may be necessary for severe cases. Large abscesses may be drained under CT guidance. Surgery is reserved for cases with complications such as perforation, fistula, bowel obstruction, peritonitis, etc. This is all about diverticulosis. If you found this video helpful and learned something new, please like this video and don't forget to subscribe for more health insights. Share this video with friends or family to spread awareness. If you have any questions or queries, drop comments in comment box. Don't miss my next video. Until then, stay informed and take care of your health. Thank you very much.